Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen, and welcome to this month's Commander's Corner. It's Thursday, February 7th, 2013. First topic I have to talk to you about, not a good one, the use of ignorant oil, that old dreaded alcohol. We had yet another DUI recently. We're up to 5 already on the year. Also had a couple incidents of underage drinking over the weekend. I mean, the legal limit here is 20, which is less than it is in the States, and we're still getting underage drinking. So remember, if you going to partake in the adult beverages, do not get behind the wheel of a car, and if you're not 20 years or older, don't be drinking in the first place. So let's clean that up a little bit, CFAY. We already have had too many DUIs this year. We're on pace to have more than we did last year, which is something we definitely don't want to have. You might have seen some Japanese soldiers running around the base this week. That's because we were doing guard and protect exercise. That's an annual exercise we do with the Japanese Ground Self-Defense Force. They work with security and they do different drills like a boat coming in the harbor that's not supposed to be there, or suspicious packages or things of that nature. So that's why they were here. That's an annual event. They were running around their trucks and everything. Honcho Patrol. Those who don't know what the Honcho Patrol is, that's a community relations event where you can go out and get with members of the city, walk around the honch, and pick up trash on a Friday night. We do this once a month. The next Honcho Patrol is on February 15th. If you are interested in participating, be down at the main gate, that's Kearney Gate, at 2215 on Friday night the 15th if you want to participate in the Honcho Patrol. The Kinnick High School Career Fair that was scheduled for February 26th has been moved. It's been postponed. They don't have the firm date yet, most likely in May, so keep your eyes open for that one. So due to circumstances beyond their control, they had to move that career fair day. And while I'm talking about the high school, I want to put a plug out there. They're still looking for presenters for the STEM conference. So please, if you're interested in that, contact Ruth Russell, the school liaison officer. She's looking for volunteers for that. For all you golfers, there's going to be the USO Goodwill Golf Tournament coming up. You can start registration March 18th. The event is actually on May 11th up at Itsugi. And if you're interested in that event, the number is 241-4894. We have a couple grand openings happening at the end of this week. Tomorrow on the 8th of February at 0900, one that's been waiting for a long time, the official grand opening of Pizza Hut. We now have Pizza Hut here at CFAY. It's down at the Seaside Cafe over there around Pier 6. So we're going to be doing a grand opening of that at 0900. And the commissary, you might have noticed, has been serving sushi, but their official opening of the Seahawks Sushi Bar is going to be on Saturday at 11 o'clock. That'll be the official grand opening for the sushi bar at the commissary. Some Captain's Cup sports coming up here in February. The Co-Rec Volleyball Tournament is this weekend on 9 February. On 11 February is floor hockey, both men's and women's. And for you runners, there's a Captain's Cup 5K on Wednesday the 13th. That starts at 11:30 over at Purdy Gym. As far as high school sports, if you're into basketball, both girls and boys teams are in action next week. The boys team's on the 12th, the girls team's on the 13th. I went and saw the girls team earlier this week. My gosh, the JV won 51-4. I mean, 4-4. That's all the points the other team scored against the girls JV team the other night. It was 4 points, an entire basketball game. For those of you who are into wrestling, next week, the 18th through the 21st of February is the Far East Wrestling Tournament. So we're going to have, I think, 11 different wrestling teams here for that one this week or something that week in nature. Hey, guys, Valentine's Day is coming up soon. I mean, it's on the 14th. Don't forget. I tried the adage that we're in Japan and the women are supposed to give the guys chocolate. Didn't fly. Okay, guys, you better get ready to go find out and buy the gifts over there and everything on special. Spring Festival, our first open base event of the year, is scheduled for the 24th of March. The city is already advertising it. We're hoping that the sakura trees will be blooming when we have it that time. We've missed the timing the last couple of years. We'll see what happens. Depends on the weather. And oh, in the spring also comes one other thing, road tax. Road tax time is coming up now. We do have some dates where we'll have them on the base over at building J196. That's the VRO building over there by Chili's. The 26th and 27th of March, and the 23rd through the 25th of April, they will be there as well. So road tax is coming up. You know, you got your road taxes paid. Okay, I'm going to take a quick break. Then we're going to have some special guests on the show.
Well, it's Military Saves Week, and the DOD's Office of Family Policy and Children and Youth wants everyone to have a savings plan. Office Director Barbara Thompson says service members should build a retirement nest egg and be ready for short-term emergencies.
We say that you should have at least $500 in a savings account for those kind of emergencies, whether it's a relocation expense or, you know, your tires need to be changed or something that you're not planning for, that you have something saved away, a little nest egg, so you don't have to seek out what I would consider predatory lenders or financial resources that may have a high interest rate and may hurt you in the long run.
Hello, CFAY. We're back from that commercial, and I got my first guest of the show here. I've got Tricia Marino here. Tricia's here to talk about Military Saves. Trish, what would you like to tell us about Military Saves?
Well, first I'd like to thank you for supporting Military Saves today. Military Saves is our campaign that happens every year. From this year, it's happening from February 25th to March 2nd. We're encouraging everybody to start saving, not creating any more debt. So by taking the Military Saves pledge, you can just go online to www.militarysaves.org. Take the Savers Pledge, only takes about 60 seconds, and that's just you saying that you're gonna commit to saving this year.
Okay, cool. So, do we have any special programs going on? Any people coming in to help them out or anything?
We do. So on February 25th, we're gonna do a cake cutting to kick off the week, and it's gonna be over at Fleet Rec on the third floor, so we're encouraging everybody to come out and get a free piece of cake about 12:30. We have a special Morningstar class, so you can learn all about Morningstar, how to log on to NKO and use Morningstar to find out more about mutual funds and different investments that you can make. Later on that evening on the 26th, we're going to have a tax prep class, so you can learn how to prepare for your taxes to make sure you get those done and turned in time. We also have special guests from FINRA, so they are the Financial Industries Regulatory Authority. They're coming to talk to us all about investments. And they're going to be here at the Benny Decker on the 27th from 1300 to 1400.
Do they bring any free money?
They don't bring free money, but lots of information and some free little gifts will go out to everybody.
Better if they just gave us money. That'd be easier to save, right?
It would be easier.
Oh, okay. All right. I understand you got something for me to sign there.
I do. So this is our proclamation. So if you could sign the proclamation to officially kick off Military Saves.
So, am I like ordering everybody to save money now?
Yeah. It would be nice.
Okay, everybody, with my signature, you have saved money. You don't even realize it. All right, this is how it's going to work. No. Okay, cool. All right. No job's complete until the paperwork is done.
Thank you very much.
All right. Is there anything else you'd like to tell us about Military Saves, or just people get out there and save some money?
Really? Please take the Savers Pledge. The Air Force beat us last year with the number of pledges they had, so this year we're encouraging everybody, please take the pledge because we want to become number one again and not number two. So it's really easy to take the pledge. You'll find pledges all over the base. You can fill them out and we'll do them for you, or you can go right online and do them yourselves. If you do it yourself for all the military, active duty, and their spouses, this year you're going to get a free FICO credit score.
So there you go. You do get something free out of it. So go for it. All right. Thanks for coming on the show and talking about Military Saves. Have a great day. And CFAY, we're going to take another break, and I'm going to have some more guests on.
Kinnick High School, a Department of Defense Education Activity School at Yokosuka Naval Base, is making a push to increase competitiveness with international schools in the fields of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics education by offering a gaming technology pilot course and an animation course. Students recently visited Tactical Training Group Pacific Detachment Yokosuka to witness war gaming firsthand. Robert Tiffany said their visit gives the students a glimpse of what types of opportunities they may have in a career in engineering and technology.
Today they were able to apply what they've seen and done in the classroom to actual simulations that the military does on a routine basis. So hopefully what we've shown them is that what they're doing by creating games, gaming is one piece of it, but there's a bigger picture that they can get involved in with as well. We have four new projects. We have the gaming technology, which is going on right now. We also are piloting an engineering class, which is a robotics class. We're piloting green technology, and we're also piloting biotechnology within the DoDEA schools.
William Rossi said high school students today will lead us into the next 20 to 30 years of war game technology.
We run war games and simulations to train the ships of the forward deployed naval force. I grew up playing games like Pong and Defender, and as modeling and simulation gets more prevalent in Navy training, we're going to need the next generation of experts in wargaming.
Petty Officer Adrian White, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
All right, CFAY, I'm back again with two more guests. I've got Linda Ledesma and I've got Rachel Nelson, both from DoDEA and the school systems, to talk about a couple of programs here. First, we're going to talk about the laptop pilot program here at Kinnick High School. Linda, you know about that. What's this program all about?
We have about 80% of the students with laptops now. So it's going along really good, and I know the teachers and the students are really excited about this new initiative. And it is an educational initiative. It's not really about the technology. It's about giving the students more resources to meet their needs and to make them, keep them competitive with the students back in the States who already have a lot of schools there, one-to-ones. And so this keeps our students with them.
Cool. Laptop computers for students.
Yes.
Well, I thought it was a high technology when I got my Texas Instruments 30 calculator as a senior in high school. I had to buy that myself and everything. But,
now we're
into laptops and
we
all
are,
that.
We are into laptops, sir.
Wow, so that's pretty state of the art. What type of laptops are they?
They're Lenovo laptops, okay. T430. They're state of the art. They're very solid machines. They're filled with all the newest resources. Memory, RAM, and all those things, but it's a little more sturdy so that the students can walk around with them and not be concerned about breaking them. And so,
if the students already have a laptop, can they use their own, or they got to use?
They have to use ours. Right. They have to use ours. That's part of the initiative, and part of what's going on is that we all have the same platform to work on, because a lot of the programs can only be loaded onto DoDEA computers. Mm-hmm. So we need to have them with our computers so that we can provide them with those programs and resources.
I know I'm very low tech. I seem like I crash my computer about every other week. If the students have any problems with them, is there technical support available?
There is certainly technical support. We have an AT, an administrative technologist, okay. And he can help with if the computer gets broken.
Right.
He's the one that fixes it and re-images it. If it's technical issues, just small problems, they come see me and we sit together and problem solve and figure out what their problem is and get them repaired. We want to give the students as much ownership as possible, so I want to help them to figure out how to fix these certain problems and to use them the best way that they can.
Are they allowed to put anything else on the computers?
They aren't allowed to download any additional programs. But they can load their own music onto it, so they can keep their music with them and listen to it on their headphones while they're doing their homework. And
all right, so within reason,
Within reason, yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
And pictures, I see you got Harry Potter all over that one.
I do. I have Harry Potter because they all do look the same.
Right, okay.
They all look the same. So all the students, they were given a little sticker that has their names on it so that they can identify theirs. But as long as whatever they put on the computer can be removed, they're allowed to personalize it and, like I said, take ownership of these computers.
Well, that makes sense. So they know which computer is theirs.
Yes.
Instead of...
Yeah.
All right.
Yes, sir.
They can't, like, do their homework on one computer and then that way give it to a friend and say, here's mine, and push
right.
it. Okay.
Right.
I don't know. Kids are pretty smart these days.
They
how long
are.
Is it going to take them before they figure out how to get around the system and everything on it?
You know, some of them are working on it. Working on it.
Sure.
I know they are. But so far, we have really, really good students.
Yeah, I know we do.
So
okay. All right. Anything else you want to talk about on the laptops? I mean, it sounds like an exciting program and a great opportunity.
It is. It's a really exciting program. Just encouraging all the students to use them and to give us feedback, because this is an initiative, and so we're learning how it works in the school, and So just continue to give us feedback from the students and parents.
If you ever give my kids homework on laptops and stuff like that, they're on their own because Daddy doesn't know enough about it. That's all there is with it.
All right.
Okay. Sure. All right. And Rachel, you're here to talk to us about the Continuous School Improvement Program.
Yes. Great. This year we are going under our external review. So Advanced Ed, there will be a whole team of people that come over to evaluate the school. And it's a huge process, and it's a something we've been preparing for the last 5 years. And so it's really important that we do well this year, and we put a lot of steps in place to make sure that we do extremely well as a school. Parents, teachers, community members will all be talked to by the Advanced Ed people to help evaluate how the school's doing.
Okay, cool. And when's this going to happen?
This will be April 22nd through April 26th that the team will actually be here. And a lot of stuff's going on behind the scenes right now. We're getting a lot of documentation in that we need to, and the district gets things ready, obviously, for them. But they will be here to visit us on the 22nd through the 26th.
This sounds like the in-serve of the school. You know, I mean, every 5 years, a ship gets an in-serve, and they like tear everything apart, and they dig into everything. Sounds like you got the in-serve team coming to see you for the school system.
We do, and they're looking for all kinds of things, like how we're using technology, how we are with the community, our relationship with the community, our data, basically how well are our students doing and how are they improving. So they are tearing through every little bit and piece to see how we're coming out.
And community and parent feedback in this process is really, really important.
It
plays heavily, I imagine.
Yeah, and they'll actually be talking to a whole set of parents. We'll have to gather a set of parents for them to talk to so that they can get feedback from the parents as well as the kids on what they think about Kinnick High School and how we're doing.
Who gets to pick the parents, you or them?
Actually, it's a very random thing. Usually random. It's just like a spreadsheet, and then it goes through and just randomly picks a couple parents.
So you can't stack the deck, like no. Load the watch bill up or anything?
I wish. Now, we do get to have student organizations talk to them, but so it's all students that will be picked for a random list, and then it's special groups of students, like our stucco and things like that, that will also speak to them.
Okay, well big thing coming up for the high school here this spring, so... We wish you the best of luck, and we're here to support it the best we can also.
I appreciate it.
Okay, ladies, thank you for taking the time out and seeing us here today, and have a great day.
You too, sir.
Thank you.
Okay, CFAY, time to wrap this edition of Commander's Corner up, and of course, none of my videos are complete without us hitting the trivia. From my last video, I referred to the show About Nothing, Seinfeld. I told you that George had found a place at work where he thought it was cool to take a nap, so where was that place? And it was under his desk. I mean, I don't recommend that to all of you now, but George used to take naps under his desk, and Roger Drake gave me the answer to that one. My sports question was, I asked who the Ravens were before they became the other way around. I asked who the Ravens were before they became the Ravens, all right? And by the way, they're now the Super Bowl champion Ravens. And they were the Cleveland Browns. I'm from Ohio, and Art Modell was one of the most hated men in the state when that happened. But regardless, Jeremy Latimer gave me the answer to that one. The Ravens used to be the Cleveland Browns. No one gave me an answer to the song lyrics I gave the last time. So here's the same song lyrics. See if you can come up with the song and an artist that did it. The goalie jumps, and the players bump, and the fans all go insane. What song is that one from, and who did that one? Okay, I got three new trivia questions to go here. For all you Trekkies, I came up with a Trekkie question. With all the science, technology, and laptops, there should be plenty of people that can answer this one. How many times the speed of light is warp factor 3? Okay, how many times the speed of light is warp factor 3? All right. My next question, this one's a little wordy, but... In 1926, the second week of February was designated Negro History Week. And the reason for this, and it eventually became what we know as African American History Month. The reason they chose the second week of February was because of birthdays of two men. Whose birthdays are on the second week of February that helped create what eventually is now called African American History Month? See if you can give me the answers who those two people are. All right. And now I got to do a sports question. And of course, you know, I love baseball. Being a naval officer was not my first choice of careers, but I had not enough talent for baseball, not enough brains to be a doctor and all that stuff. But who was the first African-American pitcher to win a World Series game in the majors? who was the first African-American pitcher to win a World Series game in the majors. And now that I'm talking about baseball, it is right around the corner. The Japanese leagues are already in spring training, and that brings me to the Yokosuka Bay Stars. Remember, our local team that plays at Opama. Their season opener is March 16th at 1300 at Opama. So remember, it's only 1,000 yen to get in, 500 if you're students. It's a great deal if you want to go see some professional baseball and don't want to have to go all the way up to Yokohama every time. And with that, as usual, CFAY, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great day, CFAY.